So we start today's topic. So our today's topic is the protoperiodism. Okay, so it is also one of the important topic under your syllabus. So in the name, that is the proto and periodism. So this proto means light and periodism means period, or we called as what is the length of that period, so it is called as periodism. So what is the significance or what is the role of this protoperiodism in the growth and development of the plant? So in detail we study this topic. So protoperiodism is the phenomenon of physiological changes that occurs in plants in response to relative length of day and night. It's called as photoperiodism. So photoperiodism is nothing but it is a response of plant to the relative length of day and night. It's called as photoperiodism. So we know that the plants, they are growing in 24 hours of that period. That is, one day consists of 24 hours. So out of that 24 hours, when you can equally divide, that is 12 hours of light and 12 hours of darkness. So according to that, that period, depending on that period which are required for the induction of flowering, on that basis this photoperiodism is, they can be determined. Okay, and what is the physiology behind the photoperiodism? That because of this response of plant to the photoperiod, these express in the form of flowering. Means once this photoperiod is they are available to the plant, then they are expressed this photoperiod in the terms of flowering, and so that's why it is called as photoperiodism. So this response is called as photoperiodism response, and this response is firstly discovered by the scientists, that is Garner and Allard, in 1920. Depending on that, the what is the period required for induction of flowering. So on that basis, the three, or they are classified the plants into three categories on the basis of requirement of length of period, length of light period required for induction of flowering. Okay, so these three categories are, first one is short day plant, second one is long day plant, and third one is called as day neutral plant. Okay, so what is the meaning of short day plant, what is the meaning of long day plant, and what is the meaning of day neutral plants? Okay, so short day plants, firstly short day plants, the plant which required a relatively short day light period, and is this light period is usually from 8 to 10 hours, means particularly this period is less than 12 hours. Okay, and continuous dark period of about 14 to 16 hours for subsequent flowering is known as, or this particular category of plant is called as short day plant. Okay, so example of short day plant is rice, coffee, soybean, tobacco, and chrysanthemum. So these are the example of short day plant, and this is the expression, that is the when they are flowering. So this is the day period means that period during this light is available. So this period is requirement is less than 12 hours, and this is the period where this there is no any light, this period is more than 12 hours. So if this condition is available to plant, then that short day plant they are flower. Okay, the second condition is that when this dark period, okay, so they are required the less than 12 hours, this is not disturbed. But when this continuous dark period of 12 to 16 hours, if they are interrupted by light, then there is no flowering in short day plant. Okay, so means that for short day plant there is a requirement of continuous dark period without any disruption. So but when the disruption is due to light, then definitely there is a resulting in no flowering. Okay, then this is about this where we provide this less than 12 hours of light. And if this dark period, they are interrupted at the end of this dark period, means not in the mid, in the end of the dark period, means then also there is no any inhibition of flowering, the short day plant there flower. Secondly, if this dark period is interrupted early in the dark period or in the beginning of the dark period, then also there is no any influence on the flowering. So means that short day plant, they are only inhibit the flowering when they are interrupted mid during the dark period, mid of the dark period. Then and there only there is inhibition of flowering. Okay, so all about this is the short day plant. So short day plant, in short day plant, dark period is critical and must be continuous. So means short day plant required the continuous dark period. So that's why it is called as long night plants. Okay, required short day, but they require the long nights for induction of flowering. And if this dark period is interrupted with a brief exposure of red light, the short day plant will not flower. Okay, so if this short, if dark period is interrupted, then there is no flowering in case of short day plant. And maximum inhibition of flowering with red light occurs at the middle of the critical dark period. Okay, so that middle of that critical dark period is inhibited due to this interruption of light. But however, this inhibitory effect of red light is can be overcome by subsequent exposure of far red light. If this far red light is the exposure to that period, then this effect of red light will be overcome by this far red light, that is the light of wavelength 730 to 735 nanometer. The interruption of light period with red light does not have any inhibitory effect on the flowering in short day plant. So whatever that light period, so if this light period is disrupted with any red light or far red light, does not affect on flowering. So that's why, so light period disruption does not have any inhibitory effect on flowering of short day plant. Okay, and prolongation of the continuous dark period initiate early flowering. Okay, so what is the most important for short day plant? That is the continuous dark period. If this continuous dark period is available, then that short day plant will flower early. Okay, so this is the some conditions are given short day plants for the flowering. So if this dark period is, if light period is more than dark period, then there is no flowering. If dark period is more, if this is the dark shade is indicate that dark period is more, and light period is yellow is indicate the light period. If this light period is less, then they are flower. If this dark period is interrupted, if this dark period is interrupted with red light, there is no flowering in case of short day plant. If this red light is, effect of this red light is inhibited by again exposure to far red light, FR means far red, then there is a flowering. Then red light, again far red light, and again red light, then there is also, there is no any flowering. And last condition, that is if red light, again far red light, again red light, and again far red light, then there is also flowering. So that whatever the effect of red light is overcome by the exposure to far red light. Okay, so this far red light, they are induce the flowering in case of short day plant. Okay, then second category is a long day plant. So this long day plant means the plant which required longer day light period. Usually it is 14 to 16 hours in a 24 hours of cycle for subsequent flowering. These plants are called as a, this plant is called as a long day plant. Okay, and this plant required very short dark period. So that's why it is called as a short night plant. What is the example of this plant? That is wheat, radish, cabbage, sugar beet, and spinach. So these are the example of long day plant. And in long day plant, the light period is critical. So in case of first short day plant, the dark period is critical. But in case of long day plant, the light period is critical. So a brief exposure of red light in the dark period or the prolongation of light period stimulates flowering in long day plant. So if this dark period is interrupted with some red light and there is a continuation of prolongation of light period, this condition are promotes or they are induced or stimulates the flowering in long day plant. Okay, so it is the exact opposite of the short day plant. So this is the condition. If this day period is more than 12 hours and dark period is less than 12 hours, then there is a flowering. This is the actual condition required for flowering in long day plant. Okay, if this continuous dark period is increased and light period is decrease, then there is no flowering in case of long day plant. And if the dark period is interrupted with any red light, then there is a flowering in case of long day plant. So this is the about the long day plant. Then third category is the day neutral plant. So these plant flowers in all photoperiodic range, means in short day condition and in long day condition also they are flower. So this is called as a day neutral plant, which flowers in the photoperiod ranges from 5 to 24 hours continuous exposure. So example is the tomato, cotton, sunflower, cucumber, peas and certain varieties of the tobacco. So this is called as a day neutral plant, means the flowering is not influenced by any day length. Then in the recent year, there is some subcategories under these main three categories. Okay, so subcategories on the basis of that, the intermittent categories. So in the intermittent categories involved, that is long short day plant, and another category is short long day plant is also recognized. So what is the meaning of long short day plants? So these are originally the short day plant, but must be exposed to long day during early periods of growth, so for subsequent flowering. So this plant is called as long short day plant. So example is bryophyllum. Second category is the short long day plant. These are the long day plant, but must be exposed to short day during early period of growth for induction of flowering or for subsequent flowering. So example it's certain varieties of wheat and rye. So these are the example of two category, that is long short day plant and short long day plant. Okay, now come to the what is the difference between short day plant and long day plant. So the plant which flowers when photoperiod is less than the critical day length. Okay, so this is called as a short day plant, and the plant flowers when photoperiod is more than the critical day length. Okay, so we come to the point, that is the what is the meaning of critical day length. So critical day length means that for example we divide the 24 hours in 12 hours and 12 hours. The short day plant required the 12 hours, that is the plant flowers when photoperiod is less than the critical day length. Okay, so they are not required the 12 hours of light, they required the 14 hours of dark period. So that's why the plant flowers when photoperiod is less than critical day length. And they, when this 12 hours, if the light is 11, 10, 9, then this condition is favorable for short day plant. The plants flowers when photoperiod is more than the critical day length. Okay, so 12 hours of light, but sometimes is day period is increased to 13, 14, then this long day, this condition is favorable for long day plant. Then interruption during the light period with the darkness does not inhibit flowering. If this light period of the short day plant is inhibited with the darkness, then there is no any inhibition of flowering in case of short day plant. But in case when interruption during light period with the darkness, they are inhibit the flowering. If the light period of this long day plant is disturbed with a darkness, then there is an inhibition of flowering. Then flowering is inhibited if the long dark period is interrupted by flash of light. Okay, so dark period of the short day plant is, if they can be disturbed or interrupted by a flashlight, then there is an inhibition of flowering. But in case of this, flowering occurs if the long dark period is interrupted by flash of light. Okay, so flowering occurs in case of the long day plant, if a that dark period is interrupted by a flash of light. Okay, so here's the difference. Then long, continuous and uninterrupted dark period is critical for flowering. Okay, so this is the critical dark period is required for flowering in case of short day plant, and dark period is not critical for flowering in case of long day plant. Here the light period is the critical. Then flowering does not occur under alternate cycles of short day and short light period. Okay, so flowering does not occur when there is an alternate cycle of short day and short light period. If you are interrupted this short day plant with some time in between that light, then there is a no flowering. But flowering occurs under alternating cycle of short day followed by still shorter dark period. Okay, so this they can be whatever the dark period they are interrupted or they are with light, then there is a flowering in case of long day plant. Then we are come to the term that is the phytochrome. So what is the meaning of phytochrome and what is the role of this phytochrome for this induction of flowering? So in the previous two types, that is short day plant and long day plant, we observe that that red light in a short day plant, if that red light is you can interrupt it during the dark period of short day plant, they inhibit the flowering in short day plant. And whatever the effect of red light is inhibited by the subsequent exposure with a far red light. Okay, and similarly that in case of these long day plant, the critical light period or the interruption of the dark period with a red light, they promote the flowering or they stimulate the flowering in long day plant. So means that red light in short day plant, if they are interrupted, there is no flowering. But in same condition, the same period is interrupted in case of long day plant, then there is a flowering. So why they are occurs? So this inhibition of flowering in short day plant and stimulation of flowering in long day plant, they are involved in the operation of that proteinaceous pigment. That proteinaceous pigment is called as a phytochrome. And this proteinaceous compound, that is phytochrome, is present in the plasma membrane of the cell. And this particularly, this phytochrome having two compounds, that is chromophore and protein. So this chromophore is attached to, that protein is attached to this chromophore. And what is, where they are exist, they are exist in different parts of the plant, that is roots, coleoptiles, stems, hypocotyles, cotyledons, petioles, vegetative buds, flowers. So in case of flowering tissue, seeds and in some of the developing fruits of higher plants, these phytochrome they are present. So this, what is the form of this phytochrome? This pigment phytochrome, they are exist in two forms. The first form is called as red light absorbing form, and which is designated as PR form. It is PR means phytochrome red. Okay. And second form is called as far red light absorbing form, and which is designated by PFR. PFR means phytochrome far red. Okay. So these two forms of the pigment are photochemically interconvertible, means these two forms, they are interconvert with each other. Okay, so when they are interconvert, when PR form, that is phytochrome red form of the pigment absorb red light, that is 660 to 665 nanometer, it is converted into PFR form, that is phytochrome R red form. Okay, and when PFR form of the pigment absorb red light, that is 730 to 750 nanometer, then it is converted into PR form. Okay, so PR form absorb red light and PFR form absorb far red light, and they are converted into each other. Okay, and the PFR form of the pigment is gradually changes. So this means that is phytochrome far red form of pigment is gradually changes into PR form in dark. when there is a dark condition. In dark condition, when there is no light, during this period, the PFR form is gradually converted into PR form. Okay. So now, what is actually happens when this PR form and PFR form, they are induced the flowering in short day and long day plant. So it is considered that during daytime, means when there is a light is available, during daytime, the PFR form of the pigment is accumulated in the plants and which are inhibitory to flowering in short day plant. So this PFR form, they are accumulated during daytime in this plant, and this PFR form is have an inhibitory effect during day period on the short day plant, but it is stimulatory in long day plant. So it is stimulatory means that when this dark period of the long day plant, they are interrupted with this light, then there is a flowering increase of the long day plant. So these particularly long day plants, they are found in case of this, means particularly long day plants does not having any inhibitory effect of this PFR form. Okay, so during the critical dark period, means critical dark period means that in the short day period, during the critical dark period in short day plant, this form is gradually changes to PR form, resulting in flowering. Okay, so during dark period, this PFR form, which are accumulated during daytime, so they are slowly converted into PR form, and there is a resulting in flowering during the in the short day plant. And a brief exposure with a red light will convert this form again into PFR form, and thus there is an inhibition of the flowering. Okay, so actually we know that this slowly this PFR form is converted into PR form in the critical dark period. So as naturally they are flowering when there is no interruption, but due to interruption of red light, so this red light is absorbed by the again this PR form and converted into PFR form. So and PFR form, they are inhibiting flowering in case of short day plant. So what is the reversal effect, reversal of this inhibitory effect of red light during this critical dark period in short day plant by subsequent far red light exposure. Okay, so we know that this whatever that PFR form they are formed, this inhibitory effect of this form is they can be done by subsequent exposure to the PFR form. So this PFR form after absorbing far red light, they are, that is 730 to 354 nanometer, will again be converted into PR form, and there is a flowering in case of short day plant. And where, what is the condition in the long day plant? So prolongation of critical light period or the interruption of the dark period by red light. Okay, so this when this dark period is interrupted by this red light in long day plants, will result in further accumulation of PFR form. So already they are exist, but due to interruption of red light, again there is a formation of PFR form, and this again there is a PFR form is formed and of the pigment, and they are stimulate the flowering in long day plant. Okay, so this PFR form, they inhibit the flowering in case of short day plant, but they are promoting the flowering in short day plant. Okay, then what is the major difference between PR form and the PFR form? So it is blue green in color, PR form. PFR form, they are light green in color. It is an inactive form of phytochrome and does not show any phytochrome mediated response. So it is an active form of phytochrome and hence shows phytochrome mediated response. So PFR form is called as the active form, and it has maximum absorption in red light, that is 680 nanometer. It has maximum absorption in far red light, that is 730 nanometer, and it can be converted into PFR form in red light, that is 660 to 665, and it can be converted into PR form in far red light, that is 730 to 735 nanometer. So it is found diffused throughout the cytosol. So they are diffused in cytosol, and it is found to be discrete areas of cytosol. So they are in some of the areas they are found. Then in PR form is contained many double bond in pyrrole rings, and the PFR forms contains rearranged double bonds in all pyrrole rings. So this is the major difference between these two, that is PFR, PR form and PFR form. Okay. Then what is the significance of photoperiodism? So photoperiodism is an example for physiological preconditioning. Preconditioning in that once the vegetative growth is over, then it stimulates the flowering. So in the stimulation of flowering requires its preconditioning. So this preconditioning is because of this photoperiodism. So that's why photoperiodism is an example of physiological preconditioning. Okay. So what is mean that the stimulus is given at one time and the response is observed after months. Okay. So means once that light is absorbed by the plant due to this photoperiodism, they show their effect after the several months. Okay. So that's why it is a conditioning. So exposure to longer photoperiods hastens flowering in wheat, and the earing is hastened. Earing or in the wheat, they are promoted due to this photoperiod. During long light exposure, PR form is converted into PFR form and flowering is initiated. If dark period is greater, means if dark period is greater and PFR form is converted into PFR form, that inhibits the flowering. Okay. So when the dark period is greater in case of the long day plant, then definitely it inhibits the flowering, because this whatever the PFR form, they are again converted into PFR due to the long dark period, and that's why it inhibits the flowering. Then the important phytochrome, they are mediated photoresponse in plants, including photoperiodism, seed germination, sex expression, bud dormancy, rhizobome formation, leaf abscission, epinasty, flower induction, protein synthesis, pigment synthesis, auxin catabolism, respiration and stomatal differentiation. So particularly on this, all these whatever the responses which are occurs during the plant's growth and development. So phytochrome, they are mediated, response is mediated through this, all these activities. Okay. So this is about the photoperiodism, classification of plant on the basis of requirement of day length, that is short day, long day plant and day neutral plant. Then what is the role of this, and what is the, and again subcategory, that is short night plant, short long day plant and long short day plant. This is the subcategory. And also we studied the, what is the effect of these different treatments, and this defect is because of the presence of phytochrome. Then what is the phytochrome? Then what are the different types of phytochrome, that is PFR form and PR form. Okay. And we also discuss about the, what is the difference between short day plant and long day plant. Okay. So, and what is the significance of this photoperiodism? So it is nothing but it is a preconditioning which are required for the induction of flowering in plant. Okay. So there is one part of this lecture is remaining, that is the, what is the photoperiodic stimulus induction and the vernalization. So it required the half an hour again. So we completed this in the next lecture.